Hello, Pythoneer. In this video, I will show you how to use the DeepSeek R1 model to create a simple ongoing chat with history. Like in the UI, we can give an input, see first the reasoning output, and then the answer stream to the console. Let's not waste any time and get straight into it. We start by importing the OpenAI class and some error handler from the OpenAI library. Then we initialize the client instance using the OpenAI class, where we pass first our API key 2. If you don't know where to get one, head over to deepseek.com or check out my latest video on the DeepSeek API, link in the description. Here you can see how to get started. Second, the base URL to route the prompt to the right API. Here, api.deepseek.com. Next, we create a helper function to initialize a list of dictionaries where we can store all user inputs and model outputs, or even the reasoning. For this video, I'm keeping it simple with a local variable, but you can get more advanced, like managing multiple chats and storing them in a database. Let me know in the comments if you would like to see a chat handling here as well. Since I mentioned the reasoning multiple times yet, I want to note that at DeepSeek we get back the reasoning output as well and can use it. Unfortunately, on the OpenAI API, that is currently not possible to protect the OpenAI infrastructure, or so, open source for the win. Okay, let's get further. We now use this function to initialize our conversation list variable using the initialize history function. This is where we read from and write to later. After we create a chat with reasoner function used to interact with the model, and we will run as endless loop. Inside here, we first use a global statement to give the function access to the global variable conversation history. With a while loop that runs while it's true, we keep the chat going. Then, we use the input function to ask the user for the input prompt and store it in the variable user input. At the end of the video, we will add here two more ways how to handle the reset and quit the chat. But for now, I will show you only the basics. We then use the user input and append it to the conversation history with the format of a dictionary, where he defines the role of user and pass the user input to the content key. The next step is to initialize the stream using the client chat completions create function from the OpenAI library. Here we pass now multiple things like the model, which is currently the R1 reasoning model, the message where we pass the conversation history to give the model the context of the past inputs, and last we set the parameter stream to true to get the chunk or part-wise feedback instead of the full response at once after a longer wait time. To stream the response to the terminal, we loop the chunks over the stream and then first handle the reasoning output and then the final output, or which I call here assistant output. The easiest way for me here was to print in a new line reasoning and then create an empty reasoning response string where we add the chunks to. Here is some room for improvement, but I assume here that I always get a reasoning response here. With an if statement, we check if the current chunk contains a reasoning response by using the choice at index 0 delta reasoning content, and if it contains, we use this content to assign it to a variable. We use this to print it first as ongoing text by using the end parameter with quotes and the flush parameter as true to get an instant print. Then we use this as well to add it to the reasoning response string. Here we now could also add this to the conversation history list, but I don't see benefit. Let us know in the comment if you found some, and then we can handle the assistant response by also creating an empty string at the beginning and checking now with an if is there is content in the delta choices of the chunk. Additionally, I add a check here if the assistant response is empty. If so, I print in a new line, response, to indicate the answer of the model. And then we use the same technique as above. Grab the delta.content, print it, and add it to the assistant response string. To finish the basic runnable function, we just need to append the assistant response string to the conversation history list with the role assistant to build up the history. And that's it. This is how it generally works, and you could use it already like this. If you watched until here and you like it so far, please consider giving it a like and subscribe. Before we see the function in action, let me add some small improvements. The first thing is to add some additional function to handle the chat. Therefore, we can add a check to the user input where we say, if the user inputs the word exit or quit without any additions, we print goodbye and break the while loop. To clear the history and start with a new chat, we can add an elif here to check if the user input was clear. If so, we initialize the initialize history function with the default list again. Then we add a short feedback to the console and continue the loop. To make the code even more bulletproof, we can wrap the full stream function inside a try block and add some error handlers to catch, for example, API errors. Therefore, We use the authentication error and the API error class from the OpenAI library to get specific feedback on errors that are API related and a general exception to catch general errors. And that's it now for real. Let's see what we can do now. When we run the code, we first get the part shown of the user input where we can enter our prompt. To show you that the model uses the context, I ask first to tell me a joke and later just another one without context to prove it knows to tell a joke. As you now see under the reasoning part, we see how the model tries to answer the question, which I really like to read and see, because it has some interesting parts where it looks like it has real thoughts, even if they are mimicked. Let us know in the comments what you think about the reasoning, and then we get the response with a shallow joke. Then we come back to another user input because we use an endless loop. When I now say another one, we see in the reasoning that the model knows I want another joke after the first one, which is only possible due to the history provided to the model. And then we get another shallow joke. When I now enter the phrase clear and say again another one, we see the model doesn't know what we are referring to because we cleared the history and gives us a total random response. You should stop the video and read it because the reasoning is very funny to see. When we now write quit, the loop ends and we can't enter any more questions. DeepSeek and its API get currently attacked by other companies to bring down their services. That's why it might be sometimes unstable. That's why the page chat.deepseek.com where you can manage your API access is partial down these days. But you can go to status.deepseek.com like I show here. As you can see, there were major outtakes these days, but hopefully DeepSeek was able to fix this and we can furthermore enjoy these awesome open source model. And that's it. This is all I wanted to show you in this video. I hope this video helps you. If you enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like and subscribe. On the left is first a video YouTube thinks you should watch, and then my latest one I suggest to you. Happy coding! I'll see you in the next one.